Hi everyone, I am Arun Julka and today we will learn about amortization of loan. Whenever we talk about amortization of loan, we are interested in calculation of periodical payment or periodical installment. Periodical installment denoted by capital R and can be calculated using formula P multiplied by I the whole divided by 1 minus 1 plus I whole raised to the power minus n, where P denote present value, I denote interest rate per period, and N denote number of periods. And if we want to calculate principal outstanding in the beginning of kth period, which is equals to R whole multiplied by 1 minus 1 plus I whole raised to the power minus N minus K minus 1, and this whole divided by I. Interest contained in the kth payment can be calculated using formula R multiplied by 1 minus 1 plus I whole raised to the power minus N minus K minus 1 divided by I and the whole multiplied by I. Principal contained in the kth payment can be calculated using formula installment amount minus interest contained in the kth payment. Total interest paid can be calculated using formula amount of installment multiplied by number of installment minus present value. First example, Mr. X took a loan of Rs. 3 lakh to be paid in 10 yearly installment. The interest charges at the rate of 8.5% compounded yearly. Find the yearly payments, the principal outstanding at the beginning of 4th year, interest in the 4th payment, principal contained in 4th payment and total interest paid. In this example, loan amount Rs. 3 lakh. So the value of P, which denote present value, is Rs. 3 lakh. And interest rate 8.5% compounded yearly. So I equal to 0.085 and the number of years are 10, so N equal to 10. And we want to calculate principal outstanding at the beginning of 4th year, so K equal to 4. Part 1. Here you want to calculate capital R, amount of installment. Periodical installment denoted by capital R and can be calculated using formula P multiplied by I the whole divided by 1 minus 1 plus I whole raised to the power minus N. Put P 3 lakh, I 0.085 and N equals to 10. And after calculation, we get value of R 45,722 rupees and 31 paisa. Part 2. Here we want to calculate principal outstanding in the beginning of 4th year. Principal outstanding in the beginning of kth period, which is equals to R whole multiplied by 1 minus 1 plus I whole raised to the power minus N minus K minus 1 and this whole divided by I. Put R 45,722.31, I 0.085, N 10, and K equal to 4. And after calculation, we get the principal outstanding in the beginning of 4th year, 2,34,030.27. Part 3. Here we want to calculate interest contained in the 4th installment. Interest contained in the kth payment can be calculated using formula R multiplied by 1 minus 1 plus I whole raised to the power minus N minus K minus 1 divided by I and the whole multiplied by I. Put R equals to 45,722.31, I 0.085, N equals to 10 and K equal to 4 and we will get the value of interest contained in the 4th payment Rs. 19,892.57. Fourth part. Here we want to calculate principal contained in the 4th payment. Principal contained in the kth payment can be calculated using formula installment amount minus interest contained in the kth payment. And after calculation, we'll get the principal contained in the 4th payment 25,829.74. Part 5. Here you want to calculate total interest. total interest paid can be calculated using formula amount of installment multiplied by number of installment minus present value. And after calculation, we'll get the value of total interest 1,57,223.10. Next example, Ms. X took a loan of rupees 10 lakh to be paid in 10 years by equal monthly installments. The interest charge at a rate of 9.24% compounded monthly. Find the yearly payments, the principal outstanding at the beginning of 6th year, interest in 61st payment, principal contained in 61st payment, and total interest paid. In this example, loan amount rupees 10 lakh, so P equal to 10 lakh, interest rate 9.24% compounded monthly, so I 0.0924 divided by 12, which is equals to 0.0077. And number of periods is equal to 12 multiplied by 10, so n equals to 120, and k equal to 61, because we want principal outstanding at the beginning of 6th year. This implies 12 multiplied by 5 plus 1. Part 1. Here you want to calculate capital R, amount of installment. Periodical installment denoted by capital R and can be calculated using formula P multiplied by I the whole divided by 1 minus 1 plus I whole raised to the power minus n. Put P equals to 10 lakh, I 0.0077 and n equals to 120. And after calculation, we will get amount of installment 12,797.83. Part 2. Here we want to calculate principal outstanding at the beginning of 6th year. This implies k equal to 12 multiplied by 5 plus 1, which is equal to 61. Principal outstanding in the beginning of kth period, which is equals to r whole multiplied by 1 minus 1 plus I whole raised to the power minus n minus k minus 1, and this whole divided by I. Put R equals to 12,797.83, I 0.0077, N equals to 120, and K equals to 61. And after calculation, we'll get principal outstanding at the beginning of 61st month. This implies beginning of 6th year, 6,13,068.83. Part 3. Here we want to calculate interest contained in 61st payment. Interest contained in the kth payment can be calculated using formula R multiplied by 1 minus 1 plus I whole raised to the power minus n minus k minus 1 divided by I and the whole multiplied by I. Put R equals to 12,797.83, I 0.0077, n 120, k 61, and after calculation we'll get interest in 61st payment 4,720.63. In part 4th, we want to calculate principal contained in 61st payment. Principal contained in the kth payment can be calculated using formula installment amount minus interest contained in the kth payment. After putting the value of R and interest of 61st payment, will get principal containing 61st payment 8,077.20. Part 5. Here you want to calculate total interest. Total interest paid can be calculated using formula amount of installment multiplied by number of installment minus present value. And after calculation, we'll get total interest of rupees 5,35,739.60.